Look. If you had a random substance and you needed to find out how much it releases, what do you do? His palms are sweaty, knees weak, calorimeter ready. The substance in the bowl already. Water steady, he's nervous, but on the surface he looks calm and ready to start the test. But he keeps on forgetting where he broke down. Suddenly the calorimeter goes so loud, he opens his mouth, but the substance had reacted out. He's rushing out, heat is now gushing out. Record the energy, how? Check the thermometer, blast, snap back to reality. Oh, the potential energy stored so cleverly inside the bonds, released so rapidly. Yo, he knows the formula though. He represents the delta T, here we go. The heat capacity of water is 4.190. He knows that and he's pro at the thermodynamics first law. That energy can change the heat to and from. He uses it to find the delta H and choose the more.
Don't lose yourself, the calculations, components, you know them. You better apply Hess's law. You only get one shot, do not miss the negative sign. If the reaction is exothermic, you better lose yourself. The calculations, components, you know them. You better apply Hess's law. You only get one shot, do not miss the negative sign. If the reaction is exothermic, yeah.
Heat's escaping from system to surrounding. Time for more calculating. Let's begin as the reaction moves forward. We begin to observe more heat release, substance burning. There are new products forming. Calorimeter pressure is constant, only grows hotter. The entropy is positive and growing. We can tell by the temperature of the water. Temperature is just the measure of kinetic energy, and there's no order. Heat increases and particles move farther. It's out of control, there goes the hot water. But the reaction is done, it formed new product. The more they move, the more heat flowed. Energy conserved and we lost nada. Hess's law predicts how reaction unfolds. I suppose we're now done, but the class goes on.
You better lose yourself, the calculations, components, you know them. You better apply Hess's law. You only get one shot, do not miss a negative sign. If the reaction is exothermic, you better lose yourself, the calculations, components, you know them. You better apply Hess's law. You only get one shot, do not miss a negative sign. If the reaction is exothermic, yeah.